One of the things that people have been saying throughout this IGF, both in plenary sessions and in workshops, people have been speaking to the power of social networks as spaces where individual citizens can speak truth to power, spaces that help to make government and other institutions more accountable to individuals. And that this is happening all over the world across a range of political systems, and that governments in all over the world are also responding positively and using social networks to have better dialogue with their citizens. But there are a few trends that are counteracting the potential of social networks to be a force that can truly help citizens participate in public life. And that may perhaps be contributing to social networks acting as more opaque extensions of incumbent power in some situations, rather than as transparent conduits between citizens and institutions. And I don't want to take up too much time because I know we want to have some discussion, but I'll raise four basic points. One has to do with the liability that is placed by governments on social networking services for the content that users are putting on sites. Now, in some jurisdictions, international social networking sites end up being blocked because the sovereign government is not happy with some of the content being posted on the sites. And in some of those jurisdictions, what then ends up happening is that a robust set of domestic social networking sites evolve. And the social networking sites that are hosted domestically are held liable for all the content that their users are posting on the site. And so in order to comply with government requirements and government, the particular government's definition of what constitutes legal speech, these social networking sites end up having to develop large departments of people whose job it is to police content. And so in addition to child pornography and things that are universally considered bad in some jurisdictions, certain political speech is also considered to be against the law, and companies are expected to censor that speech. And so then what happens is that international social networking sites that want to operate in certain jurisdictions have to make a choice, either to be blocked to users in that country because users may post things that the local government objects to, or agree to develop a locally hosted site in the local language, which would then be subject to greater local jurisdiction and agree to police it.